the solution for this example. So the first one is we want to highlight those, and you can see we want it to turn red if it's less than 40%. Notice these are numbers. So when we refer to 40%, what we're saying is take the difference between the smallest and the biggest number, and the bottom 40% must turn red. So if it was up to 10, then those would be red, but you can see it needs to be a little bit further. So we've highlighted that. I'm going to go to the icons. I can choose the icons I want. Depending on your version, they do look slightly different. If I do that, you'll see it's close, but it's not quite right. So let's go to our manage rules and see what it's doing. And you'll see Excel has guessed that what you want is that it must be green when it's bigger than or equal to 67% of the range. You'll see here we want it to be 80%, so we need to just change that to 80. It then must be yellow between 40 and 80, so that 33 must change to 40. And when I say OK and apply, you'll see us now correct. It's we're controlling what turns red, yellow, green. For the next one, we now want to be red if it's less than the absolute number 3, yellow, green, and you'll see we've chosen ticks, crosses, and exclamation marks. So again, I can highlight it. I'm going to go find the icon set, so it's that one there. When I click on it, Excel guesses and it decides that's how it's going to do it. You can see it's completely different. So let's go into Manage Rules, Edit Rule. So Excel has decided to use the percentage method, which means that it compares the numbers from the smallest to the biggest. In this case, we've got particular numbers we want to emphasize. So the first thing we do is we must change the type to be numbers, and then we can specify it. So green if it's bigger than 13. So notice not bigger than and equal to, but bigger than 13. Yellow when it's between 3 and 13, and red if it's less than 3. So I'm going to put a 3 there. So that looks about right. Okay, and apply it. And you'll see now it follows our rules. For the last one now, we want to be green if the number is bigger than whatever's in here, and red if it's less than. And note we don't have an option for what's equal to. So let's just go there, conditional formatting, go to the icons. You'll notice that my ups and downs is always the yellow option as well. So let's just choose that for now. Again, we need to go manage the rules. And you'll see Excel automatically does the percent. We're going to change it to a number and a number. And we're going to say be green when you're bigger than or equal to, and I'm going to link it to the cell here. Then it says be yellow when you're less than 0, whatever's in there, and we're actually going to link to the exact same thing. So we're going to say look there. When I say OK and apply, you'll see that this happens, and notice there's no yellow. And that's because the way conditional formatting works is if it's bigger than or equal to whatever's in there, the 14, it automatically turns green. Only if that's not true does it actually go to these other steps. So what you can do is if I refer to the same reference point, it actually ignores this one. So then we've just got an up and a down.